Fatala Fatu and welcome to Tagata Pasifika.
Kia ora, Malo Ni on the show today. Is this budget going to help the housing crisis?
Mena put on a fashion show for Fiji.
Always going to do a fashion show because we wanted to launch our upcoming collections. We heard about the Cyclone Winston event in Fiji, so we thought we could marry the two events together.
And it's been 10 years since she won Best Pacific Female Artist at the PMAs. Annie Grace is back with a new album that's helped heal the heartache.
The journey is just, it means so much to me. Just to be here in front of you, talking about my life, because I should have been there.
It's nice to have you back, Annie. But first, here's your Pasifika news brought to you by Seinafolava, Sanele and Chadwick.
Thank you, JP, and thank you, Marama. Good morning. Well, new spending in health, education and social services is a feature of Budget 2016, although there's little extra relief for people suffering in Auckland's rental housing market. Government has a social investment package that includes $347 million over 4 years for vulnerable children. There's more money for district health boards and extra in education for schools to target students most at risk of underachieving. But community workers say those initiatives tiptoe around the real problem facing many Pacific people, the lack of affordable housing.
Where families are in houses they can afford longer term, I would suggest 60 to 70% of the social issues fall away. So, you know, the government's focus really does have to be ensuring that every child, irrelevant of ethnicity, irrelevant of colour, every child in this country, black, brown and blue, is housed in an affordable home long term.
The government announced $41 million will be set aside for emergency housing, and there's also more money for social housing to help free up land in Auckland. But community leaders say that does nothing to ease the suffering of those already living in cars and garages across the city. And we'll bring you more on what the budget means for our Pacific people later in the show. So while there's serious concern for Auckland's homeless, there is one silver lining in the form of South Auckland's Te Puea Memorial Marae. The Marae opened its doors on Tuesday in response to the plight of desperate families living in cars and garages. Community support in the way of food and clothing rolled in as Marae staff went about trying to find longer-term accommodation for families. Marae Chairman Hurimoana says it's about providing relief for the winter.
It's been awesome. It's been overwhelming in terms of support, and we still need that. Families are slowly coming in. When I say slowly, there'll be an amount of anxiousness for sure because, it takes a big person to come in to ask for help. And they're coming in. Our team here are doing some assessments. And then from there, we're working very closely with agencies and actually anyone who can help provide some sort of relief, temporary relief through the winter period.
So far, the Marae has helped three families find a home, with many blaming the housing crisis on rising rents and lack of affordable accommodation for low-income families. Well, Pacific students continue to thrive at the Manukau Institute of Technology. Of the 1,072 students to graduate this week, 248 of them are Pacific. On Wednesday, Pacific students got together with family and friends for a special Thanksgiving ceremony in Manukau. MIT's Manager of Pacific Development says it's encouraging to see more Pacific graduates across a variety of fields.
That's just an indication of the numbers that are growing within the MIT community. And then at the same time, it's in certain really key areas where we might be underrepresented, like in business and information technology, and also in nursing and health studies. Our other areas with trades and also with creative arts, that's another area that's starting to grow as well. And I think it's just a matter of really investing that time and just getting behind our kids when they're studying.
Among the graduates this year is one with a PhD, three with MBAs, and 185 receiving bachelor's degrees. Well done, guys and girls. The Festival of Pacific Arts is on in Guam at the moment, and while Pacific nations are well represented, so too is New Zealand's Pasifika community. Our representatives are part of a 100-strong Māori and Pacific delegation, which features performers and artists. Delegation member Lisa Taouma says there's a wide variety of people, art and performances on offer.
What you can see at this festival is just so wide-ranging. And it's just like this huge assortment, not just of cultures, but of disciplines. I mean, they've got a floral arts competition. They have a food, a culinary arts component of the festival. where they have the different food of the different islands. It's a really complex and epic program, so we're all trying to make our way around the different things, but it's like you turn a corner and there's some amazing other kind of art form and other kind of island doing something.
The festival is held every 4 years and brings together Polynesia, Micronesia and Melanesia cultures to help celebrate traditional and contemporary arts. And finally, Wellington's Pacific community came out in support of the Fiji fundraiser last weekend. Held at the Michael Fowler Centre, the I Love Fiji concert featured local and international acts including Hawaii-based George Fiji Vaikoso and soul diva Aradhana.
Hey, this is Aradhana, and I just want to say thank you to everyone that came out and supported this cause. Fiji needed you, so thank you so much.
This is George Vaikoso, a.k.a. Fiji. I want to say thank you to all those that participated tonight. We can't thank you enough, and we all only can ask that God may bless you a millionfold and renaka wakalewu.
Funds raised from the concert will go towards community projects in Fiji, which was ravaged by Cyclone Winston earlier this year. And that's your Pacific News. Back to you, Marama and John.
Thank you.
Whaftai te lelava, Seinafolava.